One of the most useful questions to ask when you're building a low-fidelity prototype is whether a user can easily make the app do the thing it's supposed to do. This may sound like a very basic question, and it is, but it's actually the most vital thing to ask at this point. For instance, one of the things a user might want to do in our example app is check off a task they've completed. We need to think about how a user will achieve this task from the starting point of, I have opened this app. For a first-time user, we may need to have an instruction screen, but in general, there are three common patterns for dealing with user flow. The first is to have an app that does only one thing, and so only have that one screen. A good example of this is your common calculator app. The second is to have a main screen that functions as a menu of options for various things that users can do in the app, and then have each task occur on its own screen. Finally, you can have the first screen of the app be a place where the users can complete the most common task the app will be used for, and have a secondary screen for the menu. So, in our case, we can't use the first pattern since our app has multiple functions. That leaves us with a choice between a user flow which starts on a menu screen and having a user flow which starts on a screen on which the user can check off tasks. As time has gone on, the second pattern has become much more common. It is generally better to be able to isolate the most common use cases and have those achievable from the main screen, like this. For the same reason, mobile notifications are best when the user can perform some action directly from the notification without opening the app itself.